Sunday of Ordinary Time, gathering our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Standing before God's word, gathered before the altar, we are mindful of our frailty, our weakness, and our sin, and we ask God for mercy and forgiveness. You were sent to heal and forgive those who are sorry for their sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You nourish and strengthen us with word and sacrament. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You call each one of us to be your disciple. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send? Who will go for us? Here I am, I said. Send me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Word of the Lord.
Thanks be
standing by the lake of Gennesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing, but at your command I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come to help them. They came and filled both boats so that boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him and all those with him, and likewise James and John, the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to the shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord. On February 7, 1976, after my deacon intern supervisor, Father Frank Polly, called me by name, I stood before Bishop Walter J. Shaner, who would ordain me, and said, "I am ready and willing." I, like Isaiah, was eager to be about ministry. We heard in our first reading the Lord saying, "Whom should I send?" Isaiah replied, "Here I am, send me." I thought, as I am sure Isaiah thought, I knew what course my ministry would take. Was I wrong? My ministry has taken twists and turns I never imagined. Yet, God has blessed me all along the way. In our second reading, St. Paul acknowledges that his life took a major turnaround on the road to Damascus, turning from being the one who persecuted the Church of God to the great apostle bringing the good news to the Gentiles. And in our gospel reading from Luke, we hear how Jesus, wanting to have a better vantage spot to preach to the crowd that was pressing in on him, he got into the boat of Simon Peter, pushed off a little way from shore, and he began to teach the listeners. After he was done speaking, Jesus directs the fishermen to put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch. Simon Peter and his companions were certainly worn out from having unsuccessfully fished all through the night. But Peter responds, "At your command, I will lower the nets." To his surprise, they caught so many fish that he had to call for the other boat to come help him. This interruption of his daily routine marked the beginning of Peter's new life as an apostle of Jesus. God calls each one of us, maybe not to a lifetime of service as a prophet, an ordained minister, or a missionary to some far-off corner of the world, but it might be to cross the street to share an act of kindness, or just to listen quietly so that you can hear what God is calling you to do today. Let us listen today, so that we can further the building up of the kingdom of God in our midst. Amen. Amen. Now let us together make our profession of faith with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Standing now before the Lord, let us express some of our needs in our prayer for the faithful.
For the Church, that sinners are not abandoned, but are offered a more fruitful life and invited to follow Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our leaders respond with compassion and comfort for those in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have been made to feel unclean or unworthy, that they may come to know forgiveness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those preparing to return to the Lord during this coming season of Lent, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who await mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual healing, that God's grace may touch them and bring them healing, including Peter Bertolone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the departed may rejoice as they are called into fellowship with Christ, including Bruce Barron, Reverend George Kowalski, Senior Priest, and Michelle Lahan. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. As a worshiping community, we are united with our family of faith. Together we pray for the following intentions: Ann Fritsch, Dennis Sahaki, Edward Nielokowski, the Dulian family, Barbara Hannes, Alexander Placidin, Salvatore and Capruccio families, Joe Warner, Angeline Tringali, and for wisdom for our government leaders. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Lord God, we place ourselves and our needs before you. In the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, who lives with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, our loving and almighty Creator. May the Lord accept the sacrifice and hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and good of all His holy Church. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with angels and the whole company of saints, we praise you as together we sing. Supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins." Do this in memory of me. The mystery of church spread throughout the world and bring to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Alan, our Bishop, the clergy, religious, and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember us, our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Hope, her husband Joseph, with the Apostles, St. Germain, St. Gertrude, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, so that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, and you say to us, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Let us pray. O God, you have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one cup. Grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As I mentioned in my homily, tomorrow, Monday, February 7th, is my 46th anniversary of ordination. It has been a blessing, and I thank you for journeying with me, and I plan to continue to journey with you as pastor as long as I am able. Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God continue to bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let us go to love and serve the Lord and one another. Thanks be to God.